The state's health leaders are bracing for impact of this fourth wave of COVID-19 brought on by the Delta variant, and fighting misinformation has become just as hard as fighting the virus. Courtney Ann Jackson has the latest.
State Health Officer Dr. Thomas Dobbs has come under fire by some on social media for making this comment during Friday's State Medical Association chat.
Anti-science Nazis on social media try to find anything to make an excuse, right? It's the excuse monkeys.
One state representative has called for his resignation over the comments. We asked Dobbs for his response.
I apologize for kind of getting away from a sense of calm decorum, but I'm frustrated. I'm mad. I'm upset. I'm depressed. Because we're going to watch people needlessly die over the next month or two for no good reason. There is a mountain of lies and disinformation that is being promulgated by a relatively small number of misinformed, disillusioned people, and it's leading folks astray.
The importance of getting scientific information to the public came up throughout the Department of Health's latest briefing, and they still don't want to sugarcoat it.
Y'all, we're going to have a rough few weeks. Delta is hitting us very strongly.
Lackey Memorial Hospital in Forest has seen an uptick, and they're hoping the treatments that are now available will keep the number in the hospital down.
Probably three quarters of what we're testing is positive now. It's kind of deja vu. It's kind of we're doing a lot of outpatient antibodies right now, probably at the same level that we were in February, March.
Dobbs says the Delta variant essentially doubles the risk of transmission and says it takes less time and less exposure to catch compared to the original strain.
Normally, we might see two or three transmission cycles within a small group or family, and now we're finding extensive webs. We find a case and we can link it to multiple families over multiple exposures because it's that much more contagious and it's a lot easier to sort of track it down in these massive outbreaks.
Courtney Ann Jackson, WCBI News.
Something to note, Dobbs said the vaccine continues to hold up well against the Delta variant, but previous COVID infection may not be enough to protect you.